the Thermobaric Revelation. Hidden within the labyrinthine caves of Afghanistan, Osama bin Laden looted capture, ensconced within subterranean complexes hundreds of feet below the surface. In a strategic maneuver in March 2002, the U.S. Department of Defense, alongside the United States Air Force, unveiled their latest technological marvel. The BLU-118B Thermobaric Bomb. This weapon, a brainchild of scientific ingenuity led by Nguyet Anh Duong, was expedited through development, forsaking numerous safety protocols due to pressing exigencies. Upon its debut, the bomb's unprecedented lethality sparked a debate among experts, many of whom argued it should never have been brought into existence. Amidst escalating tensions in the Middle East, U.S. forces anticipated that this formidable ordnance would penetrate the deepest recesses of the mountainous refuge and obliterate the cave networks. Strike Eagle's flight. The McDonnell Douglas F-15E Strike Eagle, a versatile strike fighter developed in the 1980s, had served as a cornerstone of the United States Air Force's arsenal since its introduction in 1988. This aircraft, with a payload capacity of up to 23,000 pounds, had been pivotal in numerous conflicts, from Desert Shield to Operation Inherent Resolve. On March 2, 2002, a solitary F-15E from the 335th Fighter Squadron Chiefs embarked on a mission over the Shah I Kot Mountains, situated near Afghanistan's eastern frontier. Armed with the inaugural operational BLU-118B, the aircraft participated in Operation Anaconda, a coordinated effort involving CIA paramilitary officers and allied forces aimed at dismantling Al-Qaeda and Taliban strongholds. The targeted offensive. Reconnaissance had identified a critical enemy cave complex teeming with high-value targets, as noted by General Richard Myers, then chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. With precision, a targeting laser marked the location, enabling the F-15 systems to calculate the optimal release parameters. However, the bomb's descent, guided by its fin and airfoil adjustments, culminated in a premature detonation above ground, squandering its destructive potential. Despite this, the explosion's magnitude was heralded as a testament to the bomb's potency by its creators. Crafting the weapon. Lieutenant Colonel Tom Ward, arriving at the Department of Defense in July 2001, was tasked with devising a tunnel defeat weapon aimed at neutralizing North Korean subterranean nuclear stockpiles. Although unversed in bomb construction, Ward's expertise in project management propelled him to collaborate with scientists and contractors, ultimately proposing the production of 20 thermobaric warheads at a projected cost of $67 million over 3 years. The September 11th attacks, however, accelerated the need for Ward's weapon. Ward repurposed existing components, selecting the BLU-109 casing, a robust penetrator developed by Lockheed Martin, capable of breaching 6 feet of concrete. With the urgency of the Afghan conflict looming, Ward committed to delivering a functional bomb within 60 days. This necessitated an effective explosive payload, leading him to Nguyet Anh Duong. Duong's contribution. Nguyet Anh Duong, who had fled Vietnam in 1975 and sought to repay her adopted country through her work with the Defense Department, accepted the challenge. As the program manager for explosives at the Naval Surface Warfare Center Indian Head Division, Duong had an illustrious record, having developed numerous high-performance compounds utilized across various military branches. Duong proposed the experimental PBXIH-135 compound, an innovative mixture of HMX, polyurethane rubber, and aluminum powder. This composition, capable of sustaining a high-energy thermobaric explosion, was engineered under extreme time constraints. Disregarding standard safety protocols, Duong's team at Indian Head produced over 600 gallons of the compound. By mid-November, despite initial setbacks, the team successfully crafted a batch of Blue 118 billion bombs ready for testing. Impact and controversy. By December 14th, the urgency surrounding the bomb's deployment reached a climax, with intelligence suggesting Bin Laden's presence in Tora Bora. Duong observed the bomb's deployment from a control room, witnessing its profound efficacy. The subsequent Pentagon release of test footage showcased the weapon's devastating potential, eliciting both acclaim and condemnation. International observers decried the bomb as a weapon of mass destruction, conflating it with napalm. In response to the backlash, the Defense Threat Reduction Agency clarified that the Blue 118B conformed to international treaties and was not as deadly as purported. A critical miss. The March 2nd, 2002 mission's ultimate failure with the bomb missing its intended target underscored the challenges inherent in precision-guided munitions. Captain Randall Haskin of the 4th Fighter Wing explained that procedural adjustments during the bomb's release altered its trajectory, resulting in a missed strike. Despite this, Duong took immense pride in the endeavor, viewing the Blue 118B as a symbol of American resilience and unity during a time of crisis. In a moment meant to break us, we stood united, transcending our differences. That unity is our strength, she reflected.